Racing through the streets of Monrovia, an ambulance transporting a suspected Ebola case. Inside, a scared and helpless patient. He waits and waits, and no one comes. This is the reality of a system on the brink of collapse. Over the weekend, angry healthcare workers clashed with the Liberian president over wages.
What we're trying to make sure that you get, okay?
They've had enough. Hazard pay and improved equipment among the demands. A work slowdown is in effect at two of the city's four treatment centers, and they're threatening to strike if the demands aren't met. Ambulances have already been turned away here.
Currently, you have 3,000 deaths multiplied out by five. So you have 15,000 deaths in the next 4 weeks if this is not handled very soon.
So given those consequences, why do you still want to strike?
I don't want to strike, but the president has to listen to the mass of health workers out there. They are angry people. You don't want to have angry people knocking at your doors during this kind of emergency situation. So the president has to listen and act very fast.
An overstretched healthcare system beginning to crack when it can least afford to. The president personally now asking healthcare workers to stay on the job. Doctors Without Borders, MSF, run the city's fourth treatment center, the largest in the world. But they are nowhere near full. Not because people aren't getting sick. The worry is it's because they may no longer be coming forward.
So now we have enough beds, but the system is not good enough, and it's taking time to rebuild the trust in the system.
Trust that they won't be turned away like so many have in the past, and that they'll get the treatment they need. Rebuilding that trust is another layer of complication, and one that could undo what gains have been achieved here.
A lot has been said about the international community's response, but these are the men and women who have been risking their lives and staunching the wounds since the beginning of this crisis. And now they're asking that the world does not forget about them.
Pause, and the ambulance remains waiting. Nima Elbagir, CNN, Monrovia, Liberia.